Winds west of Donegal Bay are heavy, the sailors all say, but none can compare with the winds that blew there in the northeast Atlantic that day. At 11:30 the ocean was calm, we thought it could do us no harm. At 2:00 it was choppy and overcast too, but nothing to give us alarm. At nearly 3:30 the mainsail was reefed, the fishing was so good that day. At 5:00 in the evening waves covered the bow and we questioned our judgment to stay. Winds west of Donegal Bay are heavy, the sailors all say, but none can compare with the winds that blew there in the northeast Atlantic that day. Oh, Captain, we've traveled, the nets are all foul with snarls that no man can untie. He said, cut 'em loose and turn into the wind, or surely we're all gonna die. The mainsail and topsail, we hauled them all in, but the winds just kept growing in force. From wave crest to tropping at angles too steep, and we're further and further off course. The winds west of Donegal Bay are heavy, the sailors all say, but none can compare with the winds that blew there in the northeast Atlantic that day. McCarthy and Ryan were swept overboard, they'll meet at O'Hara's no more. Tell poor old Bridget and Meg that their lads won't be back to the shore. The bowsprit snapped off and the ship broke apart, tons of water poured in through the bow. Oh, Captain O'Connell said into the skiff, don't argue, just do it right now. The winds west of Donegal Bay heavy, the sailors all say, but none can compare with the winds that blew there in the northeast Atlantic that day. O'Connell's a seaman of courage and skill, with knowledge from many years past. We hungered and thirsted for 4 days at sea, then pulled into Broadhaven at last. The fishing is good in the ocean past Black Rock, young sailors, please listen to me. The weather is risky from fall until Easter for sailors gone west to the sea. The winds west of Donegal Bay are heavy, the sailors all say, none can compare with the wind.